So I think that love is something like a funnel. You walk into a room, and the first thing you do is you look at somebody, and they're either in or they're out. Too big, too small, too fat, too short, too thin, too pink, too green, they're out. Then they open their mouth, and their voice will give them away. If they've got the wrong accent, they're out. You very rapidly pick up their goals, whether you can fit into their lives. And what I'm trying to add is the second half of this component. It's now thought that more than 50% of who you are is built by your biology. It is that second half of this puzzle that I'm trying to bring to the mating process. And then I took a look at 28,000 Americans to see who from these different four types is attracted to whom. And that is embargoed material, so I won't tell you about it. My book comes out in, it's called Why Him, Why Her. It comes out in January. But I've begun to understand some of the biological attraction to one person rather than another. So I'll close with this. Women tend to get intimacy from face-to-face talking. We swivel until we're looking straight at each other. We do what we call the anchoring gaze, and we talk to each other. And I think that comes from millions of years of holding your baby in front of your face, cajoling it, reprimanding it, educating it with words. Words are intimacy to women. Men tend to get intimacy from side-by-side doing. As the man on the right looks at the man on the left will look away. And I think this comes from millions of years of sitting behind a bush on the African grasslands, looking straight ahead into the savannas, trying to hit that buffalo in the head with a rock. The problem comes when we don't understand each other. Thank you very much.